Hi all. Today I would like to share with you my experience regarding the running Ansible inside the Docker container. There are a few benefits why it does make sense. First of all, you will have completely isolated environment which does not have any dependencies on your current operation system, apart from the mounting your folders and specific files into the container. So I've prepared the lab where I will show you how to run Ansible inside the Docker on Mac and Windows. First part will be about the Mac and the second about the Windows. So if you have Windows, you can jump into the part 2 right now. Let's start. First of all, we will need to clone the repository which contain all labs files. So let's do it right now. Open the terminal and run git clone and the repository, and then change the directory to this. And let's quickly walk through the contents of the repository. To do this, we are going to use Visual Studio Code. I think it's much more convenient. So we will open this folder. There are two folders inside. First contains the data for Docker Compose, and the second is the demo playbook. This is the folder for Docker Compose. This is the definition of the Docker which will be running by the Docker Compose command. So it contains the instruction where the build instruction located and which volume is supposed to be mount into the Docker container. And the Docker file located inside Ansible folder, and this is pretty standard Docker file. So we are going to use a standard CentOS 7 base image, and then we will add additional environment variables, and then we will install additional packages into the operation system by using the YUM packet manager, and then we will install additionally Python modules by using the Python free install command. Then we will add user Ansible to the image and set the working directory on it. To run the process, we just need to go to the cheat chat and copy the magic command, then go back to the repository and change the directory to Ansible main. And yeah, we must be in the directory where the Docker Compose file located, and then we will run the Docker Compose up build and run in the daemon. This process takes about 10 minutes. So I will pause the video for a while. Okay, good. The process was finished, and now let's check if the Docker container is running. So to do this, Docker ps. Good. As you can see, the container is up, and now let's attach to the container. To do this, let's go back to our page and run another magic command. Docker exec interactively, and the ID of the container, and we're going to use bash there. Okay, we are inside, and let's check if we have the Ansible installed inside, Ansible minus minus version. Perfect. Okay, this is the one way how we can attach to the container and work locally, because basically whole data which currently present in your home directory is available here. We can show mount and grep Ansible, and as you can see, there are three volumes which was mounted. And the most important is here that our folder from our operation system, it is available here, and then we can easily jump into this folder and check what's inside. But as you can see, now we are inside the container. Another option how we can easily attach the container is to use Visual Studio Code. To do this, we can install additional extension which has the name Docker. As you can see here, I already have it. And then you will click install on the extension. You will see the Docker icon right here. And then you will click on it. You will see the containers which currently running in your system. And yeah, definitely it could be stopped. And then you will run it right here. And the cool things here that you can attach the shell right here. And you will see the open terminal right here. Ah, don't forget to set the special parameters here to be able to see the nice prompt here. You should change the configuration a bit. Yeah, here, and you just set here the bash only. So remove everything what currently present here and just set bash, and that's all. So you will see the normal path to the directory where you are right now. And let's move forward and run the demo playbook. This is the demo playbook. There are two files inside: inventory, which currently has only one single host inside, router one, and this is the IP address, this is the operation system and the credential. And the playbook is pretty simple. So we are going to set up the NTP server parameter on the device. And let's set something random here. And yeah, let's run the playbook. So we will need to change the directory to the directory where our playbook is located. Playbook here. So where we are. Yeah. And let's run it. Ansible playbook minus inventory. We will need to specify the inventory file because we don't have the Ansible configuration file right now and we don't need this. Minus minus limit. Limit. And our device is router one. And what we are going to run, we are going to run NTP playbook. Okay, let's run it. And cross fingers. And that's it, it's running. And since this is completely new value for NTP server, we expect to see changes. Yeah, it was changed. And if we will run one more time, we expect to see everything is green because the configuration was changed previously. And to verify the configuration, yeah, let's wait for a while when we will see the green. And yeah, everything is green. And now let's log in into the device directly to see, to verify that the server IP is present there. So we are inside and we expect to see this NTP server. So we will just run the show run configuration, include NTP. Yeah, that's here. Yeah, I ran a few times before. Yeah, but as you can see, it's so easy to run the Ansible inside the container. It's so easy to manage the playbook and see the result right in the same program, inside the Visual Studio Code on the same screen. So yeah, basically this is all what I would like to talk about, the how to use Docker container for Ansible. Okay, see you next time.